Let's go into the red meat piece. When you're talking about your diet, you talked about how red meats is something you avoid. I can understand from a process standpoint, you know, meats that have been heavily processed. But let's get into the details. Talk about why, as somebody who is deep into the science, this is something you don't consume.
Well, first of all, I'm not a vegan, and I sort of am an omnivore. So I will sample a little bit of everything, but I would say I'm mostly a plant-based eater, okay? 85% of my diet is plant-based. I try to cut down and or avoid red meat. Doesn't mean that I don't eat red meat, but it's very, very rare. I rarely eat red meat, but I try to avoid it because in general, you know, it doesn't make me feel that great. Red meat will change the gut microbiome pretty quickly, like overnight. It'll start to change the gut microbiome in ways that are not quite so healthy. So I try to stay away from that. There's a lot of saturated fat in a lot of ways that red meats are prepared. I mean, the beautiful ribeye steak with a lot of marbling, packed with saturated fats. I mean, so look, I'm also somebody, besides being a scientist and a doctor, I appreciate food. So I can tell you why people love a richly marbled steak. I mean, it tastes great. You know, you can really make it taste great, but it's not that good for you because of the marbling, because of that saturated fat. You keep on doing that every single day and you have a 3-inch steak, you are just really doing your health and your cardiovascular disease, your heart health, a disservice, all right? Every now and then, if you have a little bit of it, don't eat too much of it, it's okay. Honestly, if you spend most of your time eating foods that prop up your health defenses, you could take a hit or two and you'll rebound as long as you don't keep on doing it. So red meat, saturated fat. And by the way, there's another dimension to meat. Again, this is really the detail part of it. And I want people to think about this. How do you tend to prepare foods can actually make a big difference in terms of whether they're good or not so good for you. Chicken fried steak is a great example. You take red meat, okay, that's kind of a fatty, not a particularly good cut, not a particularly tasty cut. You bread it and you deep fry it, okay. Now you've taken it something that's not that great for you and you made it a lot worse, all right? And then people are eating that every single day. Not surprisingly, it's not that good for you. So, you know, what I tell people to do is if you're not a big fan of red meat, cut it down or cut it out. Find other ways to substitute it. But I'm not a categorical person, right? So every now and then, you know, you might have a hankering for a piece of steak. Don't eat the whole ribeye. Have a couple of slices. And that's another little tip that I try to give people. Some people really, really love red meat. And I try to tell people, try to cook it in the healthiest way possible. Some people want to grill their meat. And I say, you know, when you actually grill meats, you're actually putting carcinogens on it. The smoke from the fire, the saturated fat that drips off the meat on the charcoal, the charcoal burns that fat and it coats the meat with a carcinogen. And you know the char of a really, really amazingly grilled steak, you know, kind of medium rare on the inside, the juicy but charred on the outside to give you that taste. Okay. Obviously, I've had that kind of steak before. It tastes great, but not healthy for you because that char actually is a carcinogen. And with that smoke flavor also is a carcinogen. And you don't want to actually get the fake smoke flavor, which is made by chemicals, poured onto your meat either, right? So these are all the kind of details. So there are ways, by the way, to lower the harmful things on a grill. Even if you marinate your meat in a marinade mostly with fruit, chopped up fruit, pineapples, and you know, peaches or whatever it is, you'll actually neutralize a lot of the carcinogens that might come onto it. So how you cook your meat actually can make a difference as well. And I'm not telling people categorically never eat meat. There are other people that will do that. I'm sort of a reasonable guy, and I can appreciate when people really just really love to have a food. You know, everyone has something that they love that's not so good for them. What I tell people is cut down or cut out the things that are not so good for you. And if you're not, and if you're going to eat it occasionally. And if you're going to go for it, eat one that's actually really high quality and that's really going to satisfy that craving. You know, let's talk about meat for 1 second. You know, I'm a researcher and I'm well aware of the innovation of plant-based meats. Okay. Interesting idea, right? You take plants and you break them down and you reform them and you add all kinds of stuff to them to make them taste like meat. And you can even grow meat on a in a glass dish to create, you know, lab grown steaks and fish and chickens and ducks even. It's kind of crazy, but I'm familiar with that because that's what we used to do in a lab to do human research. Well, you know, the plant-based meats are really ultra processed foods. And if you're somebody who doesn't want to, who wants to avoid GMO, you know, genetically modified foods, the ones that bleed, well, they engineer the gene to make them bleed. The plants don't bleed. There's no blood, but they actually engineer a gene for hemoglobin. And so here's a thing that I would say, you know, rather than switch from your hamburger or your steak to a plant-based meat, you know, just go for the whole foods and try to find the healthiest combination. If you want to eat a steak every now and then, just get the best damn steak you can actually find and get a small piece of it. Cook it the way, just the way you want it and eat it. Enjoy it, but don't substitute it with an ultra processed food either. That's not necessarily good for you.
If you enjoyed that clip, press here for the full episode. I'll see you over there.
So while it's very important to know how to choose the right foods, it's equally important to know what foods we want to be cautious of, wary, and cut down or cut out or avoid altogether. We're feeding our gut bacteria.